Hi, I'm Jay Chapman, midfielder for Toronto FC.
Hi, I'm Jayden Nelson, and I'm a midfielder for Toronto C2.
Terry Dunfield, former TFC midfielder.
This is BMO TFC Player Pathway Midfielder Edition.
We've got three midfielders in the room here. We've got alumni who are washed up. We've got reaching almost 100 appearances for TFC, Jay Chapman, and the future, the prodigy, Jayden Nelson. I think it goes without saying we're very privileged to have a facility like BMO Training Ground. How would you say it's helped you develop not only on the field, but off the field, Jay?
I was at the academy here before we had anything like this. So I think the club, since I was on the academy, has, you know, come miles. So this training ground has been a huge part of that. Whether it's the locker room, the kitchen staff, and all the really great meals that we get. On the field, I think it's helped me just in terms of, you know, it's everything is very accessible, you know. The gym is fantastic, state of the art. It's right next to the treatment room.
There.
Yeah. Right? It's really helped in terms of being able to live a really healthy lifestyle. Having everyone a part of this organization that's always in this building, you know, you can always ask questions if you need help on something, and you know, you can just, there's just a really kind of family kind of vibe that comes with this place, and I think it's been really important.
What tips do you have when you're trying to communicate with international players?
I think just building that relationship when they first come to the team, you know, so it's really important when there's a new guy who doesn't speak the language to kind of integrate yourself with him and, you know, try and get close to them as soon as possible, because I've played with players who, if you're distant from them, that they kind of distance themselves because they don't, you know, they can't chime in with a ton of things. So I think it's close to kind of laugh with him a little bit and just make him feel comfortable.
For me, it was kind of charades.
What is charades.
It? Yeah, charades, yeah. On the field. You're kind of hand gestures over here, mm-hmm. running in behind, mm-hmm. a little bit of stuff like that.
Yeah.
And Google Translate was my best mate when I played in China.
Yeah. When you chain up a player for a while, you understand how they, like, what they like to do and like how they play. So like, I think just playing soccer at Q, you understand where he wants to be.
What advice would you guys give to, you know, a new player that's like maybe comes to a different team and has to adapt to a new formation and coaching stuff?
I think video is important in today's game, and also just putting your hand up if you don't understand something. Maybe speaking to, I know it's tough to go to the head coach, maybe going to Greg Vanney, but reach out to an assistant coach or maybe someone like Jay, a Canadian international, played almost 100 games, someone that really understands the game model, and say, hey, give me a hand, I don't quite understand this.
I think it's important for players to be able to adapt and execute whatever the coaches throw at you. So I think what I like to do is video is, like you said, I just think visualizing my role in that formation and then just try to do my best.
You know, once you get to the kind of first team level, you have to be adaptable. You have to understand how the game works, and, you know, asking different opinions here and there definitely helps you too.
I like that. So it's almost trusting in your training, and then it almost becomes intrinsic when you get on the
pitch. Yeah, because I mean, the coach is setting up things that you have to do throughout training for a reason, you know what I mean? They spend a lot of time watching video themselves and then presenting it to us and then laying out a session for us that's going to help us prepare each week for the game, right? So, you know, we have to trust in them that they know what they're talking about, and then it's up to us to kind of enter the game and do the things that we're supposed to do and that we've been working on.
We touched on game model, Jay. You've got a real X factor. You can sort of create something out of nothing. Do you find it difficult sort of sticking to that game model and then waiting for that opportunity to sort of go and show what you can do? How do you sort of deal with that?
Well, I think it all depends on how the game is going. Like, let's say they're more tight on me during the game, then I'm not going to want to dribble as much. I'll probably play 1-2 touch, but I think it all depends on the way how the game is flowing, and that's how I want to play. You guys have any advice for making the first team?
With you know, a player of your talent at such a young age and with all the resources that you have here, trying to get better every single day, and when you do get your opportunities with the first team is to not take it for granted. Don't be afraid when you come up and train. A big thing that I felt when I first signed that helped me a lot and was able to kind of integrate me with the team and gain the respect of the first team players was it's at meals or stuff like that. Just kind of integrate yourself with the bigger personalities on the team, you know, because that kind of gets you involved with everything, and the coaches take notice of things like that.
You never know when your opportunity is going to come. You never know when that phone call to train is going to come, or you never know
when maybe there's a Gold Cup on and players are needed or there's injuries, and just be as prepared as you can for that opportunity. Oh, what a cool opportunity this was. I think it goes without saying, this has kind of really brought this eclectic group of midfielders of TFC together, and I, for one, have learned a ton, and can't wait to watch your careers unfold, and all the best to both of you.
Thank you. Appreciate that. Thank you.